So now we're connected to our database, hopefully. Let's just change this to a database one, which doesn't exist, and we can see what we're returning. SQL DB database one. Okay, let's refresh. Okay, let's just try and specify this in here. Just blah, for example. Come back, refresh. Okay, it's still working. I guess what we're going to do at this point is we're going to specify MySQL DB, and we can also say or die, and we can say con error, the error we specified before. This could be anything. It could just be you could just say or die without some without text. So let's try and refresh and see what happens. Okay, so could not connect. The reason for this is that we've specified the database as a underscore database one when this database doesn't exist in our collection of databases. So let's delete the one and see what happens. You can see that now we're connected. Okay, so this is a pretty bad way to go about things. Now, eventually I'm going to include all this in a single file. And what we can do is we can use include within PHP to include this anywhere we want to use our database. So it's a lot better way to work everything out. And including it means that you don't have to keep specifying the code that we've written just here. So I'm going to get rid of this echo here. I'm going to put at just there. And I'm going to get rid of the error message that we've supplied in here. Okay. In fact, I'm going to get rid of the whole line. So at the moment, if we just echo out OK down here, you can see that everything is working fine. It's going to echo out OK. We've selected everything correctly and everything's working. But now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create an if statement. And I'm going to say if, and I'm going to copy this into without the semicolon. So let's delete them too. Copy that into an if statement. So if this returns true, then we want to do something. So we want to set up another if statement with a block here, and we want to include this in here. So I'll put this all in for now, and then I'll run through what we're doing. So what we're doing now is we're saying if MySQL connect is true, so if this has connected and there's no errors, remember we can put an at sign in front of these so they don't give us an out an error if they don't. So if MySQL connect blah blah blah, then go inside, and if MySQL connect DB, then we can say okay. And we're returning okay again. So what happens if it doesn't connect? What I'm going to do is instead of writing just MySQL connect and just MySQL select B, select DB, I'm going to say if not, then in here, let's come back. The best way to do this would be to combine them into a single if statement. So I'm going to say if not MySQL connect and not MySQL select DB echo, or we can in fact die, so that's probably a better idea, die, that's it, we can just say die, okay, maybe give an error, so we can say con error, that should be okay, yeah, okay, so MySQL connect, we're performing this here, we're saying if this hasn't worked, or we should be doing actually, so or this hasn't worked, kill the page and connection error. So let's refresh. Okay, everything's worked because we haven't killed with a connection error. Now we can say else echo connected. So we can refresh. We're going to remove this connected display message because we don't want to obviously we don't want to display this to the user every time we're connecting to our database. Now let's change something. So we'll change this back to Alex. Refresh. We've got an error. We can obviously put our... Oh no, that'll be there. We can put our at symbols in there so we just get our could not connect error back. So now let's change this database to one, but we'll change that back to root. We're still getting a could not connect error. So we're killing the page if we can't connect for either reason. And if we're not, then we're carrying on down to here. So we're killing the page if we get an error. Because if you have a lot of, if you've got a lot of need to access a database on your page, there's no point echoing your page if you can't connect to the database. So for example, if the database is down for any reason, this will also produce a connection error. So that's basically how to connect to your database and how to handle errors in the correct way if for any reason you can't connect to either your database or connect to your server or select your database.